Good morning, Jesus. Good morning, Daddy. Good morning, King Jesus. Good morning, Father. Glory to God, saints. Can we just love on Him? Can we just release the hearts, the thumbs up? Can we just welcome Him? Come on, can we just welcome Him? Thank you, Jesus. Good morning, Sister Dolores Shaw. God bless you. Good morning. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Can you tell someone good morning after you tell the Lord good morning? After you tell the Lord good morning, can you tell someone good morning? Asil, Carla, Easy, good morning. Bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Sister Lorna Smith, God bless you. Good morning. Thank you, Jesus. Can you do me something? Can you share the anointing? Can you share this life? Please take a second and share. We're going to worship God this morning, and we're going to pray, and we're going to praise God, and we're going to hear what the Lord has to say to us this morning. Amen. Come on in. Come on in. Come on in. Come on in. Happy Wednesday, co-pastor Taliba Lynch. Bless you. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Love you. Good morning. Come on in, everybody. Thank you, Jesus. Good morning, Shy. Come on in. Please share. Invite someone. Amen. We're going to go into worship. Take a moment and share. Welcome the Spirit of the Lord. Yes, God. Sister Shirley Scott, bless you. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way. We are desperate. We are waiting for you. Pastor Bryce, good morning, mommy. We are desperate. We are waiting for you. Thank you, Jesus. Come on in. Bless you. Bless you, everybody. Good morning, daughter. Good morning, Chanel. Good morning. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Can we just begin to worship God? Can we begin to worship Him? Evangelist Donna Dharma, good morning. Warrior, God bless you. God bless you. Come on in, everybody. Bless you. Glory to God. We thank you, Jesus. Come on, we welcome the Spirit of the Lord. Come on, we welcome Jesus. Can somebody begin to welcome the Holy Spirit? Come on, tell Him He's welcome in your home. Hallelujah. Tell Him He's welcome, glory to God, on your job. Amen. Wherever you are this morning, amen, just begin to welcome the Spirit of the Lord. Amen. Can we love on Him? Can we give Him glory? Amen. Can we give Him praise? Can we give Him honor? Amen. Can we just worship Him? Amen. Can we adore Him this morning? Amen. Can we just begin to lift up the name of the Lord Jesus Christ? Amen. Because He's worthy, amen, to be praised. Amen. Do you know how beautiful, how good it is, amen, that you got up this morning? Amen. Praise God. And the first thing you can do, amen, amen, is begin to praise God. Begin to thank Him. Begin to tell Him good morning. Amen. Come on, somebody. I want you to help me. Amen. Don't let me praise Him by myself this morning. I want you to tap right in with me. I want you to type. I want you to press. Amen. Praise God. Whatever you got to do, but just get into the worship this morning. Because before we pray and before we ask God to do anything this morning, amen, we're going to acknowledge Him as the King of Kings. Amen. The Lord of Lords, the I Am that I Am, the worthy Lamb, glory to God, that was slain for us. Amen. He didn't have to do it, but He did. So we give Him glory and we give Him praise and we worship Him. Come on, somebody, lift up your voice and give Him glory. Hallelujah. Give Him praise. Hallelujah. Give Him worship. Amen. God, we thank You. God, we welcome You now. Thank You, Jesus. Come, Holy Ghost. Let Your presence take over the service. Let Your anointing take over Your servant, my God. In the name of Jesus Christ, the anointing One, sit upon me. Oh God, rest upon us, Lord. Breathe upon us as we worship You, God. Come on, somebody. Give Him glory. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Come on, Zion. Where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Hallelujah. Your presence, Lord. Come on, we worship Him this morning. Holy Spirit, You are welcome. to be overcome. Can we love on Him? Can we worship Jesus? Hallelujah. Your presence, Lord. We welcome you, Jesus. Come on, sing to the Lord Zion. There's nothing worth more that can never come close. Nothing can compare. You're my living hope. Hallelujah. Your presence, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lift your hand and tell Him this morning. I've tasted and seen, had the sweetest of love, where my heart becomes free, and my shame is undone. Thank you for your presence, God. Your presence. Come on, somebody, lift up your voice and sing to Him. Oh God, come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what I come on, worshipers, to be overcome. We welcome you, God. We worship you this morning. God, we welcome you this morning. Come flood. Fill the room, God, where your people are this morning as we worship you. Come on, somebody, give Him a thank you, Jesus. Can we raise a hallelujah to Him? Come on, Zion. He's worthy. He's worthy. We give you glory, God. Oh, worship your name, Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. God, we welcome you this morning. God, we give you glory. More aware. Come on, somebody, worship the Lord this morning. Come on, somebody, give Him glory this morning. Come on, somebody, give Him praise this morning. Come on, somebody, worship the Lord this morning. Come on, lift up the name of Jesus. Lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, Zion, release your hallelujah this morning. Come on, somebody, tell the Lord, thank you, Jesus. We worship you, Jehovah Jireh. We magnify you, King of Kings. We exalt your name this morning. God, you're worthy to be praised. God, you're worthy to be honored. Father, we magnify, we glorify. Father, we lift up your name this morning. Come on, Zion, open up. Open up your mouth and give Jesus, amen, a praise this morning. Open up your mouth and give Him, amen, a hallelujah this morning. Open up your mouth and give Him a thank you, Jesus. Can the church worship God? Can the redeemed lift up the name of Jesus this morning? Jehovah Rohi, we give you glory. Jehovah Makadesh, we honor you this morning, Jesus. Amen. We welcome you, Jesus. We glorify your name. Come on, everybody. Release those hearts. Release those tongues up. Lift up those hands and worship God this morning. Lift up those hands. Open up your mouth. Hallelujah. And lift up the name of Jesus. Open up your soul. Open up your spirit. Oh, God, we give you glory. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. We worship you. Hallelujah. We worship you. 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 We give you glory, God. Hallelujah. Shandala Basaya. Hallelujah. 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 Somebody open up this morning. Open up and give Him glory. open up and give him praise. Somebody thank him for waking you up this morning. Thank him for sparing your life. Thank him for keeping you in your right mind. Thank him, amen, for loving you. Thank him, amen, for life this morning. Come on, worship him. Worship him. Have your way, Holy Ghost. Have your way, Jesus. Come on, Zion. Come on. Hallelujah. Can we release our praise? Can we release our worship as we are under the open heaven this morning? Hallelujah. Hey, Amashanda. Shall overflow where the broken shall be. Open heaven. Oh, glory to God. We are under an open heaven. Oh, God. We are under an open heaven. Come on, somebody, declare that. We are under an open heaven. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Echo Shataya. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Somebody worship him. Jesus. 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 Can we release the name of Jesus? My God. My God. My God. My God. My God. All glory to God. Can the people of God release the name of Jesus in the atmosphere this morning? Release the Nebuchadnezzar. Release the name of Jesus. Miracles, signs, and wonders, we declare it this morning. Oh, we worship you, God. We're getting ready to go into prayer. Hallelujah. We're getting ready to pray. We're getting ready to pray. Ibabakoshataya. I feel the anointing of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah this morning. I need everybody to release your hallelujah. Give him the highest praise this morning. Give him the highest praise this morning. Give him the highest praise this morning. Elamashatarababayasa. Hiloshanda mama masataya. I feel the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. We're getting ready to pray. Maxing every prayer warriors just to join me in prayer this morning. I'm asking you to go with me this morning into intercession. I'm calling on the intercessors this morning to join me in prayer as we enter the throne room boldly to make our requests be made known today. This is the day that the Lord has made. It is a brand new day. It is a day that we have never entered into before. It is a day that we have never seen before. And I don't know about you, but I need the direction of God today. I need the presence of the Lord today. I need the Spirit of the Lord to be with me today. So if you need Him today, glory to God. Hallelujah. Just begin. Amen. Hallelujah. To go with me. As we anoint ourselves today, it's fasting and prayer. We fast from 5 to 1 this morning as we ask the Lord to consecrate us, as we ask the Lord to heal the body of the sick, as we ask the Lord, glory to God, to restore the broken and the lost. As we ask the Lord to save, amen, the unsaved, and to bring back the backslider. As we ask the Lord for His divine intervention in our life this morning. I want you to touch and agree. Those of you that are fasting, amen, as you know, it's Wednesday morning and we fast together on Rise and Command Your Day International Ministry. We fast today. Oh, glory to God. The Bible encourages us that these kind, amen, there's some things that you're going to have to fast about. There's some things, glory to God, amen, that you have been praying and you have been asking God, amen, to move. You have been asking God to do. There's some things, glory to God, Zion, where we cannot, amen, we cannot just pray about. But there's some things, glory to God, where we are going to have to turn down our plate and we're going to have to look to Father, the Father Jesus Christ, amen, to turn things around. There's some difficult situation. There's some attack. There's some things, amen, that is coming up against you, amen. But the Lord encouraged us, amen, that these kind come it not but through prayer and fasting. Amen. There is a way out of this. There is a way out of it. Glory to God. Amen. Praise God. And I want to touch and agree with each and every one of you as we fast and we pray on today. Amen. Praise God. I'm asking you to share this life. Share Eba Kashanda. Share the anointing. Amen. Those of you that are fasting with me on today, I need you to just anoint yourself. Glory to God. Anoint yourself this morning. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Anoint yourself. Glory to God. Anoint yourself this morning. Amen. As we are going down into prayer, Temple of Restoration Outreach Ministry Saints, amen, Rise and Command Your Day Covenant Partners, amen, we are fasting today. Amen. Together. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Ikarodobo shata. Amen. Praise God. Encourage everybody to write down, glory to God, in your book. Amen. I got mine. Write down, glory to God, your target, your prayer target, your fasting target. Amen. Praise God. Because God have a way of answering prayers. Amen. Praise God. Even when we least expect it. Amen. Praise the Lord Jesus. While I am praying, those of you, glory to God, that are not praying, amen, or even if you pray and you're finished praying, if you can just join with us, amen, just by, amen, thumbs up, amen, just, I want you to just touch and agree as we pray. I don't want you to just lay there, just sit there, amen, but release, amen, some, amen, amen, something in agreement, amen, praise God, of the prayer on this morning. Glory to God, because we need, amen, to stand together. Amen. Father, we love you, God. Amen. Amen. We love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We love you. 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 Father, we are adore you. We adore you. We adore you, God. We magnify your name. Amen. We come before your presence, God. There is no God like our God, Jehovah Nisi, Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah Makadesh, Jehovah Mekah, Jehovah Shammah. Amen. Glory to God. We come before your presence, Father, your people, Lord God. We present our body, God, even this morning as a living sacrifice. My God, this morning we ask you, amen, to search us. We ask you, mighty God, amen, praise God, to sanctify us. Father, we ask you, God, to wash us over again in the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. We ask you, God, to renew our mind. Father, we ask you, God, to renew our spirit. Father, we ask you to revive, to refresh, God, to restore, mighty God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we ask you, God, hallelujah, to have your way this morning in us, God. We ask you, Lord God, to show up, my God, this morning in our life like only you can. Father God, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to send, amen, amen, release, deploy your angels now. We ask you, God, for the open heavens over us this morning, God. We ask you, Lord God, to lead us, mighty God. We ask you, God, amen, to direct us, God. Father, we ask you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, even as we come to you in fasting, in prayer. Oh God, we ask you, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus, as we come to you in fasting and in prayer this morning, you are the yoke destroyer. You are the heavy burden bearer. You are the chain breaker. You are the way maker. You are the mighty deliverer, Jehovah Rophi. You are still the balm of Gilead. Oh God, Jehovah Nisi, you're still the one that is able to grant us victory. My God, as we turn down our plate on this morning, my God, we ask you, Lord God, hallelujah, to walk in the room where we are. We ask you, Lord God, amen, to touch us. We ask you, Lord God, to rest upon us. We ask you, Lord God, to sit upon us. We ask you, Lord God, to breathe upon us, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, we ask you to have your way this morning. Have your way this morning. Have your way this morning. Somebody in the prayer room, God, need you. Somebody in the prayer room need to hear you. Somebody in the prayer room need to see your hands. Somebody, glory to God, in the prayer room is desperate, God, hallelujah, for a move of the Almighty God. Father, we ask you to take control, amen, of the atmosphere, the hemisphere, the stratosphere, amen. Take control, Imam Ashanda, over our community, my God, in our territories. Father, we ask you, Lord God, to open up, my God, the heavens this morning, my God, in the name of Jesus. We ask you to pour out, oh God, hallelujah, upon us this morning, your anointing. Pour upon us fresh oil this morning, in the mighty name of Jesus. Mighty God, as we come before you, Lord God, to make our requests be made known. Hear us this morning, oh God, from thy throne room, and answer prayer like only you can. Father, I pray this morning, oh God, hallelujah, for the mothers of Zion this morning, my God, that I stop into the prayer room this morning. I pray, mighty God, for divine strength upon them this morning. I pray, my God, a divine, amen, amen, restoration, oh God. I pray that you strengthen their body this morning, my God, as they tap into the room, as they call on the name of Jesus, as they pray this morning. Lay your hands upon them this morning, oh God, from the crown of their head, Lord God, hallelujah, to the sole of their feet. My God, raise your hands upon them. Lay your hands upon them on this morning, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray this morning that if they're sick in their body, oh God, on this morning, I pray that you send divine healing, my God, to their body this morning. My God, evict and remove, my God, everything that is not of you this morning. Oh, glory to God, I pray, mighty God, Lord God, that if there be anybody in this prayer room this morning that is not feeling good in their body, that is feeling sick, mighty God, in their body, oh God, for whatever reason, mighty God, the affliction of the enemy, God, has come up upon them, Lord God, I pray this morning that you break the curse, that you break the curse of sickness, that you, oh God, remove the infirmities, mighty God, from your people on this this morning. I pray, Holy Ghost, hallelujah, that you will have your way, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord God, I pray against hypertension this morning. I pray, mighty God, that you regulate that thing, my God, back into normalcy, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, I pray against glaucoma. I pray against heart murmur. I pray against, mighty God, hallelujah, amen, every sickness, mighty God, kidney, polyestic disease. I pray against, mighty God, in Koraba Shandalabahaya. I pray, mighty God, amen, against cancer. I pray against tumor. I pray, mighty God, amen. I pray for divine healing over the people of God this morning. My God, I pray this morning that you remove. I pray, God, that you extract, mighty God, everything, Lord God, out of your people's body. Lord God, I pray that somebody will experience the miracle of the living God this morning. Somebody will experience the hand of God moving, God Almighty. Let the blood of Jesus run warm through their vein, run warm through their blood vessel, run, Lord God, to the cells in their body. Lord God, let the blood of Jesus, Holy Ghost, run through their body right now, God. Clean them out, God. Lord God, cleanse them out now, Jesus, in the mighty Kotoshanda, in the Rababashanda Deosa. I pray, God, that even while I pray against this sickness, that you will cover me, oh God, under the mighty blood of Jesus. Amen. Let the blood of Jesus shield us, my God, in the name of Jesus. I pray, mighty God, this morning, oh God, against, oh God, hallelujah, amen, the affairs of the enemy. My God, I pray against, Lord God, amen, every assignment of the enemy, God, that comes, Lord God, to assassinate us. Oh God, that come to, oh God, amen, Kokoto Rabat, shut up, oh God, to take our mind over, my God, to bring us in oppression and depression, Lord God. Father, we will not fear. We will not, Lord God, hallelujah, fear this morning what the, oh God, the enemy may be plotting. But God, we trust in you this morning, for you can do this morning exceedingly, God, and abundantly, Jesus, above all that we can ask or think. So God Almighty, we come and we present our case. We present our situation. We present our circumstances. We present every sickness. We present everything, God, hallelujah, before you, God, because we know this morning, hallelujah, that your hands, oh God, are not too short this morning, oh God, to deliver your people. Oh Lord, we know this morning, oh God, that your ears, hallelujah, are not too heavy, oh God, hallelujah, to hear the cry, oh God, of your people. Somebody, koto shamande, ilabasato romande, in the prayer room this morning, God, may be crying, my God, because of where they are in their life, oh God, because of the situation, my God, that is at the to shamanda, that is coming upon them this morning. But I pray, God, for your mighty hand to move, my God, and to deliver them, Lord God, out of all their troubles. Oh God, for the Bible declare that this poor man cry, oh God, and the Lord, Ekorabashanda, deliver him out of all his troubles. Lord, somebody, Koto Shamande, hallelujah, need a breakthrough. Somebody, hallelujah, need a deliverance. Somebody, oh God, need a move of God. Somebody, hallelujah, Yayayaboshanda. Oh God, come on, somebody, I need you to touch and agree with me. I pray this morning, oh God, that you remember, Baba Shianda, Lord God, Susan Fairweather Joseph. My God, touch your daughter this morning. Touch your husband this morning. Oh God, touch your children this morning. Oh God, Rabba Kandelebo Shanda. I pray this morning that you walk in the midst of them. And I pray this morning, oh God, that you cancel out everything, Lord God, that the enemy has sent, my God, to destroy and to devour them. Oh God, I pray, oh God, that you release a blessing, my God, upon their life this morning. My God, in the name of Jesus, I pray, mighty God, for Sister Debbie Dice. I pray, mighty God, Ikorabanda Shaya. I pray for her children this morning. I pray for her grandchildren, Namakotolobo Shanda. I pray, Katolobo Shaya, that you touch them this morning. My God, that you pull them out of, oh God, of every trap and every snare of the foul and every noisome pestilence, my God, that will come upon them. My God, deliver them this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray this morning, oh God, that you remember each and every one of the saints of Temple of Restoration Outreach Ministry, God. Remember those of Rise and Command Your Day International Ministry this morning. I pray, mighty God, even for the covenant partners, I pray, God Almighty, that you sit on them this morning. I pray that you will grant them a divine encounter. My God, give them, oh God, a divine encounter this morning in the name of Jesus. Overrule and override, my God, overthrow what the enemy meant for evil. Overthrow, my God, the Kotoshanda, what was planned to minimize, what was planned to bring them down, what was planned to throw them down. My God, this morning, lift them up, oh God, in the right hand of your righteousness. Lift them up, oh God, in your right hand of power. Makoto Shekerebende Sire, mighty God, remember them, strengthen them, God, for the journey. Strengthen them, my God, as they continue, my God, to run the race that is set before them. My God, send your hands, oh God, in the midst of their life, in the midst of their children's life. Oh Lord, I pray, and we fast today, oh God, that you consecrate, that you grant us a divine breakthrough, that you grant us a divine encounter. Lord, give us, oh God, the victory this morning, because you're still a Jehovah Nissi. You are our Jehovah Gibor, oh God, our commander, oh God, and chief this morning. Lord, I pray, oh God, remember, oh God, Burnett this morning. My God, sit on Sister Burnett this morning. Oh God, touch her from the double sheke, from the crown of her head, oh Rabashanda, to the sole of her feet. Oh God, remember, highly favored Gailey. My God, touch her, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Provide for her, open doors for her, make a way for her. Oh God, remember, Korabashanda, Hilababashande. Oh Lord, I pray for Sister Nerva Ricketts, God. I pray for your hands. I pray for your deliverance. I pray for your provision. I pray for your miracle. Lord God, over her this morning. Oh God, remember Nana Makondia Saya. Shade, the sister Shade this morning. Remember her daughter and her husband this morning. Mighty God, I pray that you, Lord God, direct them. I pray, God, that you cover them, oh God, under the blood of Jesus. I pray, God, that you will lead them. I pray, God, that you protect them, my God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray, God, for the helpers. I pray for the motherless. I pray for the widow. I pray for the fatherless. I pray, hallelujah, that you will deliver, that you will provide, hallelujah, that you will make a way, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, Zion, I need y'all to pray with me. Oh God, I pray for the person this morning that feel like they're going out of their mind, that feel like, God Almighty, they can't make it. I pray that even right now, in the midst, oh God, that you will lay your hands, oh God, upon them. Yes, Lord. Yes, God. Lay your hand upon them this morning. Mighty God, remember, Co-Pastor Lynch this morning. My God, I pray, oh God, that you would touch her this morning. I pray, oh God, that you breathe a fresh anointing. Let the oil of God, oh God, pour from the crown of her head, oh God, to the sole of her feet. My God, give her divine strength. Lord God, Alabashanda, Makoto Shande, for the journey, God, that is ahead of her. My God, continue to equip her. Continue to show her your hand and your glory, Jesus. My God, Satarabondiasai, Lababandiosha, clear the way before her. My God, dismantle every plan. Ayababa Shande, dismantle every trap. Makutaya Mande, dismantle every work of the enemy that will come up against her in the mighty name of Jesus. God, remember Mona Vanwick oh God, this morning. Oh God, send your mighty deliverer. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, have your way, God. Remember, hallelujah, even now, God, these prior requests, these letters, mighty God, hallelujah, I pray this morning that you will meet their needs. I pray this morning, hallelujah, for Rosemary Wilson. I pray that you touch her. I pray that you touch her body. I pray, God, for your healing power. I pray, God, for your deliverance. Remove every pain, my God, from her body. Rako Shataya, Indio Shandelbende, my God, miracle working God, have your way. Remember, my God, Romine Enris, my God, touch her this morning, my God, hallelujah, lay your hands upon her this morning, have your way. Remember John Henry's, remember Canis, God, remember, hallelujah, glory to God, Samaya, remember Jacob, remember Aaron, remember Boshekedede, and her mother, cover them, my God, under the blood of Jesus, my God, and secure them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord, remember Nikenji Burnett, my God, this morning. Lord, lay your hands upon, oh God, this young lady. My God, I pray that the power of God, that the anointing of God, that the presence of God will sit on her today. Labakoshanda, Libabandioshai. My God, give her instruction. Give her divine instruction. Ikatabandese, Libo. Give her divine, hallelujah, hallelujah, instruction this morning. Oh God, lead her and let her follow you, for you are the shepherd, my God, and she's the sheep. Lord God, hallelujah. Lord, remember the young people in Temple of Restoration. Remember Sister Samaya Palmer, Israel Palmer, Mando Shayat. Lord God, Alyssa Palmer, remember Jakari, remember Buddy Oshakea, each and every baby, in the name of the year, Aria, Lord God, remember all the children, Elabandi Oshanda, in Temple Restoration, Elabandi Osataya, Outreach Ministry this morning, Lord God Almighty, I pray this morning that you release the angel of Jesus, Lord God, this morning, oh God, to encamp, Lord God, round about them, mighty God, I'm asking you, oh God, to cancel Labakushandai, whatever the enemy has sent against them, Lord God, to attack their mind, my God, to Shiakoshanda, to blow their vision, my God, I'm asking you, in the name of Jesus, hold them, Hayashande, hold them, Jesus, hold them, God, in the palm of your hands, hold them, Jesus, don't let them go, please, Lord, hold them, Jesus. I pray, God, it doesn't matter their age this morning, fill them up, oh God, fill them up, Lord God, with the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, that was released on the day of Pentecost, mighty, mighty God, Hilo Shandai, Hilo Babandiosaya, my God, I pray, hallelujah, this morning, hallelujah, have your way, God, I pray, God, for the academic, my God, that you will increase, my God, and give them wisdom, give them knowledge, give them understanding, bring them out on honor roll as A students, Lord God, help them to love you, love Akoshanda, I pray this morning, remember Sister Doreen Reed, Lord God, remember your daughter, oh Lord, I pray that you touch her this morning, oh Lord, I pray that you rest your hands on her, my God, have your way with her, remember Jody Williams, oh God, remember Baba Nyoshaya, Adeline Bennett, her son, Lord God, this morning, Lord, I pray this morning against every attack of the enemy, God, whatever the agent of Satan. Satan was released against us. God, we overturn. We plead the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ against every assignment, every assassinated demon, my God, that come to assassinate our strength, my God, that come to assassinate our anointing, that come to assassinate the word of God in our lives, that come to assassinate our destiny and our purpose. Lord, I pray against the enemy this morning, for we know, God, you told us we have an adversary, my God, that is after our soul, my God, a devourer that come to kill, steal, and destroy. But this morning, I'm asking you, God, Lord, to let your spirit, God, you said when the enemy, oh God, come in like a flood, yes, God, yes, Lord, yes, you said that your spirit will lift up a standard. Lord, I pray barrenness to the plan of the enemy. I pray barrenness. I pray barrenness. Let the question, every seed of discord that was so concerning us and the brethren, bring barrenness to the seed. Every lying demon, every lying tongue, that was risen against us, I pray barrenness, Lord God, every seed, my God, of wickedness, Alabashanda, oh God, we will not be defeated, because your word declare that we are the head and we are not the tail. We are indeed above, God, never beneath. We walk in your grace, we walk in your power, we walk in your authority. Dismantle now, disallow now, every weapon of our warfare that has risen up against us. I pray this morning that you pull them down by the mighty strong arm, by the mighty strong arm, oh God, of the Lord Jesus. God, how can we go through our day without you? How can we make it without you? I can't do this without you, God. Hey, God, we refuse. Mighty God, to go through the day without you, Jesus. We refuse, God, hallelujah, to go, God, without you, God. But we're like Moses this morning. We will not go, God, except you go with us. We will not move, God, except you move with us. Oh God, for we believe and we know that you, God, have the final say concerning our life. I pray that every vision, I pray that every plan, I pray that every purpose of the Lord Jesus Christ will come to pass concerning us, will flourish, my God, in the name of Jesus, will spring up, my God, like living water, will spring up, God, hallelujah, God, for God, we seek you more and more, more and more. We need more of you and less of us, God. We need, take us into God. Take us, hallelujah, into dimension. My God, open up. Oh God, our spiritual life. Hey. God, I'm a son. Woo, shake on him. Hey. Hala, baba, baba, oh, shake it. God, remember Van. Remember Van Francis this morning. I pray, God, that you touch every cell in her body. I pray, God, that you rejuvenate her, God, every cell in her body. I pray, God, that you revive every cell in her body. I pray, God, that you robo shake her, I pray you lay your hands upon her. Ilo shanda from the crown of Oshe. Ila Masaya Mandu Shea Mandea. Lay your hands on Sister Van Francis. Lord God, lay your hands upon her. Oh God, have your way this morning. He karabando koshandele beyasia. Robondia shaya basaya. Oh God, remember kotele bendesia. Oh God, touch, touch, touch. Oh God, touch, touch, touch. Remember Chanel London Taylor. Oh Lord, ababayasu kondarabanda. Oh God, let your hands rest heavily upon her. Move, God, move her through every circumstance. And move her through every situation this morning. Jesus, have your way in her life. Jesus, clear the path before her. Lord, make a way, God. Oh God. I need somebody to tell him, have your way, Jesus. I need somebody to tell him, have your way, Jesus. I need somebody to tell him, have your way, Jesus. God, remember Veronica Hernan. Oh God. Lord, remember our children, Wayne. Remember God, Shane. Remember Tasha. Remember grandchildren. Remember Chanel, God. Remember Katia de Yando Shire. Rory, God. Remember James. Lord God. I pray that you walk into the life of this family. I pray, God, that you overturn every work of the enemy and overthrow and destroy now. I pray that you bring them all victorious. I pray that your hands will rest upon them. Remember Stephanie, God, Ebokoto Rabanda, divine strength, Ila Mashanda, divine strength be released upon her now in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, God Almighty, for James this morning. I pray, God, for Etosha. God, touch him, Lord God, my God, from the crown of his head, Lord God, to the sole of his feet. Lord God, let not the enemy have him. Don't give the enemy no more access to him, my God, but build a edge around him. Lord God, save him, Mandoshaya, and use him for your work and your glory. Remember Ray and Hamilton this morning, God. I pray that you touch Ray and Hamilton. Lord God, hide him from the enemy this morning. Hide him, Jehovah, in the secret place. Hide him. Convert him like you did Saul. Change his name. Oh God, remember Chebabandia. Oh God, oh God. Ika ta shebabande sataya mandush karabande hey ababaso. Lord, 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 remember my siblings ando shaya. Remember them this morning. Ida bando shaya. Touch and deliver. God Almighty, remember. Oh Lord, remember. Hey yando shanda yanda. Hey yamande yesota. Ishada rabanda kosaya. Rondobo koseta. Iba shande. Remember Minister Lorna and her husband Ricardo Shamandia. Ilaba Soramande. Oh God, touch them now. Oh God, let your hands rest heavily. Oh God, direct them. Oh God, have your way, God. Remember Natasha Henry, God. Lord, I pray that you open up the door, my God, and make a way and provide and grant her the good desire of her heart. My God, save her. My God, deliver her. Lord, touch her this morning. My God, touch her. Lord, lay your hands on her. Lord Jesus, God Almighty. Hey, Kadabaha. Hey, Dabaha. Ushandai. Amando Shekeyaba. Oh, Rabamandesi. Oh, God. Chariots of fire. Chariots of fire. Hey. Descend now, Ushamanda Yaha, from the heaven realms, angels of God, Etor Rabanda, descend, Nano Koshaya Mandaha, descend, angels of God. God, remember, ready, Bakusa, Ayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayay My God, Holy Ghost, I thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Mushika ba 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 sotora maha. God, remember Wendy Ford. Ba 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 ba. My God, my God, my God. Somebody lift your hand and give God glory. Somebody lift your hand and give God praise. Somebody lift your hand and give God worship. Touch her this morning, oh God, and deliver her. Baboko si andelebaha. Is there anything this morning that is too hard for God to do? Ikadabandi oshaya. God, iwi konda dadabaso. Labakushkandi andadabahai. Mighty God, I feel the anointing of the Boshaya Bababandosa. I feel the anointing of the living God. Ayalaba Sheketeya Mandia Sat. Oh God, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Ah, God. Yidadabando shai. Yidadabandio shatai. Somebody give God glory. Somebody give God glory. Somebody lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, Zion, lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, Zion, give God glory. He commando shine. Come on, Zion, ibababa shande. Open up your mouth and give God praise. Open up your mouth and give God glory. I need somebody to give him an advance praise. Give him an advance worship. Give him an advance worship. I'm praising you in advance, God, because the day is clear before me. I'm praising you in advance, God, because the way has been made clear before me. I'm praising you in advance, God, because you alone hold the keys to my future. I'm praising you in advance, God, because you're not giving Satan any access to me or my children or my husband. Oh, God, but they're covered. Oh, Rakande. Come on, somebody. God, cover my husband, Samora Palmer. Oh, Rabando Shai. Come on, Zion. Give God an advance praise. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hey, Baba Kushanda Labahai. Can somebody lift up your voice and give God a praise? Can somebody lift up your hands and magnify the Lord? David said, oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. When the praises go up, Hayabashanda, Rushkarabandiosai, then something will come down. Oh God, is there anybody in the prayer room that need God to? Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. My God, thank you. Shata Baba Haya. Somebody worship God. Somebody worship God. Somebody worship God. Eba koshata labayasa. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Good God Almighty. Gonna get into the word. I need everybody to share. I'm gonna get into the word. Hallelujah. Getting ready to go into the word. I need everybody to share. Thank you, Jesus. I'm getting ready to go into the Word. Trying to find my text. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. I want you to go to Genesis. Genesis chapter 25. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 25. A thought came to me while I was praying. And I just want to amen, see what the Lord has to say to us today. I want you to go to Genesis chapter 25. Thank you, Jesus. Genesis chapter 25. Hallelujah to God. Genesis chapter 25. Amen. Genesis 25. Speak, Lord, thy servant heareth thee. Let's see what the Lord has to say to us on this morning. Genesis chapter 25. Please share the anointing. I'm going to start from verses 21. While I was praying, the only scripture that came to my mind was glory to God. Amen. Genesis 25 and verses 21. We want to see what the Lord is saying to us on this morning. Hallelujah. You got it? I need you to get your Bible. When you have it, say, I got it. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. When you have it, say, I got it. Genesis 25. And verses 21. This is the only story that keeps coming to me while I was praying. Amen. It's not rehearsed. It's not recited. It's not amen. Praise God. Amen. I'm just going to speak as the Spirit of the Lord lead me this morning. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife. Thank you, Jesus. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife because she was barren. And the Lord was entreated of him. And Rebecca, his wife, conceived. And the children struggled together within her. And she said, if it be so, why am I thus? And she went to inquire of the Lord. And the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb, and the two manner of children shall be separated from thy bowels, and the one people shall be stronger than the other people, and the elder shall serve the younger. And when her days to be delivered were fulfilled, behold, there were twins in her womb. And the first came out red all over like a hairy garment, and they call his name Esau. After that came his brother out, and his hand took hold on Esau's heel, and his name was called Jacob. And Isaac was 80 years old when she bare them. I want to focus the thought that came to me this morning. And the Lord said unto her, let's go to verse 22. And the children struggled together within her. And she said, if it be so, why? Why? The text started out by showing us, amen, that Isaac, amen, Rebecca find herself in a situation. Rebecca find herself in a position, in a place. In a place called barrenness. She find herself in a situation, amen, that she could not, amen, deliver herself from. She was married, amen, and maybe they were doing everything the right way. And they have an expectation that God, it is normal, or it should be normal, that they're married and that it should actually bring forth children, because it is God's will. God told, amen, creation, amen, he said, be fruitful and multiply. God, amen, amen, created, God formed, God made Adam and gave him Eve. Glory to God, amen. With the expectation that man would conceive and there will continually be, glory to God, amen, amen, there will be conception through the womb of the woman, amen, and there will be continual productive, continual, amen, praise God, amen, praise God, bearing of children. I wonder, amen, praise God, where barrenness come from. I wonder, glory to God, amen, how barrenness started. I wonder, glory to God, amen, praise God, that if it is truly the will of God, which I believe, amen, for a woman to conceive and have children, amen, then where barrenness come from? How, amen, praise God, that barrenness came about? Amen, praise God. I want to, amen, explain and make it clear, because somebody, amen, praise God, is facing different situation. Amen, you find yourself in different position. Amen, praise God, where you're asking God, why is this? Why is this happening? Or why is this not happening? You have a why this morning. There's a W-H-Y with a question mark this morning. Amen, I want you to understand, saints of God, that it was never God's intention, amen, praise God, for barrenness to be in a woman, amen, or barrenness to be in the earth. But please understand, glory to God, that because Lucifer, glory to God, because he was cast out of heaven, amen, praise God, because sin, amen, was conceived in the earth. Amen. Sin, glory to God, amen, produces, amen, some things that God opposes. Amen. Praise God Almighty. Sin, amen, thank you, Jesus, amen, bring forth barrenness. Because if you watch, amen, if you read, glory to God, the text, the Bible tells us of the first family in the Bible, Adam and Eve, when they started out before sin, amen, enter into their heart, before sin, amen, praise God, was conceived, amen, Eve's womb was very fruitful. She was very, amen, praise God, amen, amen, she bare, glory to God, the Bible says she had Cain, amen, and she had Abel. Hallelujah. The Bible said when Cain killed Abel, amen, they went on again and they had another child called Seth. Please understand then, amen, praise God, that before, amen, Eve had eaten the apple, before she disobeyed, before she sinned against God, please understand, saints, that there was no barrenness exists. Amen, praise God. Everything that God spoke on, everything that God lays hand on, was progressively, glory to God, growing. Amen, the apple tree was bearing fruit. Amen, praise God, amen. The turtle, glory to God, amen. The birds of the air, everything was multiplying. Everything was, glory to God, fruitful, amen, before Eve disobeyed God and bring sin in the earth. Amen. Everything was fruitful. We never heard once, have we ever, never read in the Bible that Eve was barren. Amen. Praise God Almighty. Amen. Praise God. Preach, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Never did we read that Eve was barren. We read that Eve conceived and that she keep on bringing children after children. Amen. Praise God. But understand this, that on the day, amen, that the enemy, the serpent, visited her in the garden and tell her, glory to God, that God told you not to eat of this tree. Amen. Praise God. The serpent visited her and said, glory to God, if you eat of this, glory to God, you shall become as God. Amen. Amen. Praise God Almighty. He said, you will not surely die. Amen. This was his word unto Eve. He told their glory to God, that if you eat of this tree, amen, you will become as God. Amen. Praise God. And you shall not surely die. Now, please understand that this was, amen, amen, a little bit of truth, amen, with deception that is mixed and intertwined with it. Glory to God. Amen. Please understand, Zion. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. That it was not God's intention. Amen. Praise God. Amen. The Bible said, he said, you shall not surely die. But watch this, amen, the minute that Eve disobeyed God and eat of the tree, amen, there was a death, glory to God, that took place. It was called, amen, a spiritual death, amen, because she stepped out of the will of God. And because of that, glory to God, amen, going forward, we start to read about woman in the Bible. Before that, we never did. But after that, we started to read about woman in the Bible that is not able, amen, to conceive, that is not able to bring forth children, amen, because sin, hallelujah, amen, will bring forth, amen, amen, destruction upon us. I hear the Bible said the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Hallelujah, glory to God. So barrenness started, amen, after disobedience. A barrenness started, amen, after rebellion. Hallelujah. But I thank God for mercy, and I thank God for grace, and I thank God that he is a forgiving God. Because even in this text, the Bible said, glory to God, Isaac, who came after Abraham, watch this, Sarah was the other, amen, the second family, glory to God, was Adam, amen, Abraham, and Sarah, amen, because of what Eve did, Sarah reaped, oh God, barrenness, my God, because it was Sarah after that the Bible said, amen, was barren, even though God gave a word, even though God gave a promise, Pastor Bryce, because of sin, amen, barrenness came to Sarah, hallelujah, but when God released a word, amen, tell your neighbor that that word cannot and it will not return. that Isaac, the promised son, Isaac, the sacrificial son, amen, now meet a wife, and it is God's desire for her to have children. Why did God desire for her to have a child? Because God prophesied to Abraham and said, Abraham, I am going to bless your seed. I am going to bless your line. Amen. Praise God. Your seed shall be like the sand of the shore. Your seed shall be like the stars of the sky. So if there is barrenness, how in the world is he going to have seed as sand of the shore? My God, I want you to know this morning that yes, the enemy is opposing what God has spoken concerning your life. I want you to understand that yes, the enemy is opposing what God intended for your life. But tell your neighbor, if you walk in line with God, if you keep the ways of God, amen, whatsoever God promised you, it is yea and amen, and it cannot be reversed. Nevertheless, glory to God, please understand that we have an adversary that will keep on coming, amen, to attack, that will keep on coming, amen, to stop what God has spoken concerning us. Here it is that Isaac, the promised son, glory to God, that God said he was going to bless him, have Rebecca his wife, and Rebecca, amen, find herself in a place of barrenness where she cannot conceive, my God, and have a child. Lord God, this is just the plan of the enemy, that everything, glory to God, you're set out to do, he will always make it look as if God is not with you, that God is not for you. But I come to tell somebody that whatever God intended must come to pass. For the Bible said, amen, that Isaac went and entreated God. In other words, Zion, Isaac went and began to seek God. Isaac went and began to talk to God about it. I believe, glory to God, that Isaac went into prayer and fasting and supplication for Rebecca, because you have to understand that the only one that can give life and take life is God. That's where Satan defeated, because he wanted to give life to man. He wanted to blow breath in man, but God said not so. Hallelujah. So Isaac, we're on fasting this morning, and Mark chapter 9 and 29 said that these things come, glory to God, through prayer and fasting. I come to tell the saints this morning, as the Lord put this word inside of me, that Rebecca, glory to God, let me finish walk the story. I come to tell somebody to go back to God concerning the word that he spoke concerning your life and your children's life. The Bible said Isaac went and entreated God, amen, praise God, and said, God, please understand, let me just calm down and slow down a little bit. Please understand this, saints of God, everybody have a role model. Everybody has somebody, glory to God, that, amen, will set an example, oh God, over their life. Watch this. Isaac must have watched Abraham. Isaac, glory to God. Something, glory to God, amen. Because Abraham was also a man after God's heart. Abram was also one that would seek God. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Abraham and Sarah, glory to God. Amen. Praise God. Abraham lived a life before God where Abraham entreated God over and over. Abraham had conversation with God over and over. I remember reading that Abraham said to God, if you give me a promise, where is, amen, the seed that you told me about that's going to come out of my lineage? Amen. Praise God. I believe that Abraham, amen, amen, recited, rehearsed, glory to God, amen, glory to God, released the word and the promises over and over to Isaac. I believe while he was going up on the mountain, glory to God, Mount Moriah, to present Isaac as a sacrifice, I believe that Abraham had conversation with his son. I believe they sit around dinner and talk and says, son, God gave me a word. God said he's going to bless my seed and my seed will be blessed. Lord God, I believe, glory to God, that Isaac heard the promises that God gave to Abraham. And I believe that he hold on, amen, to the word that God gave his father. I believe, glory to God, that Isaac believed every word that came out of Abraham's mouth that God was going to bless him. The Bible said faith come by hearing and by hearing the word of God. Amen. Your mind, whatever you hear, amen, please understand that your mind is so powerful. It is a belief system. Amen. Praise God, that can change, that can alter your life and your destiny. So what happened here, saints of God, that I believe that Isaac hold on to the word. He hold on to the promises that God told his father. Amen. I believe that there are times when Isaac had, amen, struggled. I believe there was time when he looked at Rebecca and said, wait a minute. Why is my wife not bearing? Why is she not conceiving? I believe that Isaac had a why, just like Abraham. Can I tell the saints of God this morning that it's okay to have a why, but don't stop there. I need you to proceed. Amen. Glory to God. I need you to proceed with a seeking. Glory to God. Amen. For the Bible said, he that seeketh him, amen, must find him. The Bible said, if you knock on the door, then the door will be open. The Bible said, if you ask, then you will receive. And the Bible said that you have not because you ask not. Tell me then, how is it that some people tell us that we should never question God? How is it that they tell us that we should never ask God anything that is not right, that is a seed from the enemy? Why? Because the Bible said you have not because you ask not. In other words, when you ask, it is a question. When you ask, it is a request. When you ask, it is a petition. Oh, glory to God. That's why the Bible teaches us that when Jesus was teaching his disciples how to pray, he said to them, give us this day our daily bread. If you don't communicate, if you don't ask, you're a fool going through this earth with no direction. Amen. Glory to God. With no, amen, sense of God. Amen. Tell your neighbor, don't stop at the why. Oh God, Isaac held on to the word of God. And the Bible said he went in and he entreated God. It means he prayed. It means he seek God. I come to tell somebody this morning, don't stop pursuing. Don't stop seeking him and after God this morning, because if you continue to seek him, my God, indeed you will find him. He entreated God and asked God this morning. He said, glory to God, because his wife was barren, he had a reason. He seek God, amen, and said, glory to God, for the Lord to open his wife's womb. Watch this, Zion, after he seek God, the Bible said the Lord was entreated. Amen. Praise God. The Bible said the Lord was entreated. Amen. Of him. And Rebecca, his wife, conceived. In other words, God heard. Amen. The prayer of Isaac. God heard the request of Isaac. God heard. It was Daniel that was praying and fasting for 21 days when God released a word and said, Daniel, from the first day that you seek me, from the first day you set your heart out to seek me, greeted by your word, and I send the answer. But the prince of the airway, because when you got to understand, this is the reason. Can I teach Zion? Can I teach this? This is the reason why when you are praying, amen, there are times when you're in intercession, when you go to pray, this is how you go. You left from one place to the other. Sometimes you feel like you're going up, and sometimes you feel like you've been pushed down. Sometimes you feel like you're praying and you're about to crack something, but something press you down. Please understand that there is a prince of the air. My God, the Bible talk about the prince of the air. Amen. Praise God. Who is the Bible talking about? Satan and his angels. Many times we bind the enemy and tell him we send him back to the pit of hell. But please understand that he's not, we are in the pit of hell, because Revelation tells us that he's not there yet, but he's in the airway. So when you and I are praying, we have to be persistent. We have to stay focused. We have to press in entreating God, because while you're praying, there is a supernatural contending. My God, there's a supernatural war, my God, that is going on, because the enemy don't want you to get your blessing. Because if God ever dare answer your prayer and you get your blessing, you're gonna believe God more and more, because his works, amen, that proceed will increase your faith and increase your knowledge in him, that he is indeed the God that can do exceedingly abundantly and above all that we can think or ask. So understand this, Zion, that you gotta be persistent in fasting and in prayer, because I know today, amen, the Bible said, and the Lord, glory to God, the children she conceived after he prayed, after he fasted, after he see God, God worked out a miracle. But watch this, Sister Doreen, when God send you a miracle, some of us, glory to God, God has released a miracle and your blessing look like a curse. Some of us, God has given children and they're giving you so much trouble that you're wondering if God give you this child or the devil. Yes, God gave him to you. Yes, God gave her to you, because Satan can't conceive. He can't make nobody conceive nowhere, no how. What you need to do, mothers, what you need to do, daughter of Zion, is glory to God. Watch this. The Bible said Rebecca conceived and she felt a struggle going on in her womb. She felt, amen, struggle. Is there anybody that's feeling struggled? Is there anybody that's feeling a warfare? Is there anybody that's feeling, Lord God, like you're going back and forth? Is there anybody that feel real rough? It is rough this morning for you. The Bible said God allowed Rebecca to conceive. God did it. Somebody say God did it. God allowed her to conceive, but in her womb was two babies. Glory to God. She didn't know back then how much kids she had, because they had no ultrasound. They had no technician. They had nothing called, glory to God, an ultrasound to look and see how the baby is, see what gender the baby is. So she couldn't see what was going on in her womb. Hallelujah. That's why the Bible said, we walk not by sight, but we walk by faith. My God, for he that cometh to God must first believe that he is God, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. So watch this, Zion. They had no ultrasound. They had no technician to tell them, glory to God, what is going on inside of the womb. But she felt it. That mean because you don't see God, can I ask you a question? Do you still feel him? That mean because you don't see where his hand is going, don't mean you don't feel it. That mean because you don't understand, don't mean you don't feel it. For the Bible said she had two babies struggling in her womb. There was a war. There was a contending in her womb. But watch this, somebody. Rebecca did something that was pretty good. Rebecca, amen, went back to the altar. And
She didn't wait for, him and Isaac to go this time. But Minister Chanel, Rebecca said, listen, if you give me this thing, if you give me this baby, surely there's something that you must can do. Rebecca, glory to God, took her pregnant self and she went to the altar. The Bible said Rebecca began to seek God. The Bible, she said unto God, and he said, if it be, amen, that you did this. She said, why am I thus? In other words, God, if you gave me this, why is this happening? God, hallelujah. She asked God why. I come to tell somebody, amen, praise God. If there's something that God give you, if it is your husband and he's acting funny, if it is your wife and she's acting out of line, if it's your children and they're giving you hell, I know Shatabandiasaya, on this prayer and fasting morning, go back to God. Bring that child back to God. Bring that husband back to the altar. Bring that wife. Thing is that some of us are going it. I feel like teaching. I don't feel like preaching. Some of us, the reason why we're getting the wrong result is because we're approaching it the wrong way. What do you mean? God gives you something. It comes from him. Watch this. So then, you mean the boy that giving me so much trouble, God gave him to me? Of course he did. Satan can't give life. You mean that the husband that I prayed about that God gave to me is giving me so much hell? Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. Why is this happening? I told you. Before Eve disobeyed God. Hey, that bus shut. I got to put my phone on the charge. Holy Ghost, have your way, God. Oh, glory to God. I told you why. I told you why. Before Eve disobeyed God, there was no barrenness. There was no barrenness. Hallelujah to God. There was no barrenness. It was after. As long as sin abides, there will always be a why. As long as disobedient abides, there will always be a why. Ketoboho shata yamanda. Yes, you can be praying for that child, praying for that husband, and you're getting a counteraction. The enemy is counteracting because sin is in the earth. But what do you do? Tell your neighbor, keep on going to God. Keep on praying. The problem we have, thank you, Holy Ghost, we approach it the wrong way. What do you mean? Your son and your daughter is acting out of the norm. They're acting ungodly. They're rebelling. And they're doing all manner of stuff that is opposing what you stand for, what God's word stand for. And instead of us, the people of God, take it to the Lord in prayer and fasting. This is the arrow, please listen to me, mothers, that we make. When that child is acting out of the normal, you don't, amen, agree with what the child is doing. You don't agree. How am I agreeing? I'm going to tell you. Every time he acted out of the normal, you said some other word. You got to be careful how you speak, because what you speak is bringing, amen, a confirming. It is confirming. It's not, amen, praise God, bringing a confirmation. It is confirming, because watch this, Suzette. Your son went to school and acted, amen, real bad, glory to God. And he comes home and you got a bad report. And instead of you, glory to God, taking him and saying, son, glory to God, this is the problem we have, you know, glory to God. We don't talk, amen, not we, but some of you don't talk to your children. I was teaching in church on Sunday morning. You don't talk to your baby. You don't talk to your baby. What you do, you beat upon them. You beat upon them. How am I beating upon them? I'm not using them belt. You beat upon them with your word. What do you mean, prophet? In other words, watch this. That child come home, glory to God, acting out in school. I'm going to teach you this morning. Teach, Holy Ghost. You're acting out in school. They're rebellion, glory to God. They're doing the most in school. And you're wondering, God Almighty, I talked to this child. I punished this child. I beat this child. Amen. But the child ain't changing. Why is the child not changing? Because you're approaching it the wrong way. So what do I do, prophet? Amen. There is always an underlying issue. Nothing just happened. Nothing, amen. That child don't get up every day, amen, one day and just acting out of the norm. There is an underlying issue that propel the child to act out of line. All right, y'all want to talk truth this morning or no? You have to know how to take that child, ask God for some patience and humility inside of you, and get rid of the anger. Sit the child down and talk to your child. Son, what's going on? What happened? Amen. Praise God. I know this is not you, son. Amen. Daughter, I know this is not you. Something happened. And based on how you approach the child, mighty God, some of you come knocking the child up the head, amen, getting a belt, whipping them. You look a bad, getting good for nothing, son. When you speak like that, tell me what fruit you expect to get out of the child when you're releasing seeds of negativity. Sit the child down and have a conversation. Son, daughter, what happened? What happened at school? What happened? Before you know it, by your calmness, ask God to make you calm. I don't even know why I'm going here. Ask God to give you a calm spirit. Amen. Praise God. When you're going to listen, you, some of you, amen, you're already getting the phone call from school because you have a troubled child. What you do, glory to God, before the baby, before he comes home, before she comes home, just, amen, go into prayer. Amen. Can I tell you how to do it? Speak, Holy Ghost. Go into prayer and say, God, amen, this child is giving me a hard time. I don't know what's going on. I don't even know what to do with this child no more. Tell me how to do it. Amen. Go into your prayer closet and talk to God and say, God, he's coming home about 4 o'clock. He's coming home about 3 o'clock. She's coming home. I need you to put a calmness in my spirit. Amen. So I can talk to this child. By time the child gets home, amen, God put that thing upon you. Amen. You don't even know how, but he did it. Amen. Praise God. And while you sit there, as you begin to talk, how you approach the child, how you talk, watch this. If you approach that child in anger and you're just going off, what do you think? Most children, what they do is they cave in. They shut down and they don't want to talk. Amen. Praise God. But if you ever I feel the anointing of God sitting on me. If you ever, amen, have a calmness, Lord God, hallelujah, and ask the Lord Jesus to help me to deal with him by the time he comes at 4 o'clock from school, then the Lord is going to touch the child's heart. And before you know it, Zion, the child is going to open up and say, Mommy, I just need your attention. Daddy, I just need to hang out with you. Mommy, you have not been paying me any mind recently. And I know we used to talk. Mommy, you used to play with me. Mommy, you used to talk to me. Mommy, we used to go to the park, but you're not doing it anymore. And I'm sorry, Mommy. I just was acting out because I need your attention. And if you ever do it this way, you're gonna get less negative results, less negative report. My My God, there's some children, Lord God, they're very smart. But all of us, Lord God, I don't know. God, somebody say, help the parent, Jesus. They're coming out with D's and E's and F. Hallelujah, glory to God. And they were never that kind of a child. And you're wondering what in the world is going on. They're rebelling, because as long as sin remains, there will be rebellion and disobedience. But how we treat it, find the symptoms and diagnose it, then treat it. Good God. We pass the some of us diagnose before we find the symptoms. Find the symptoms. What are the what is the problem? What's going on with you? What's going on with you? I'm coming. God's gonna help some of y'all today. Find the symptoms. What time is it? Glory to God. You gotta find the symptoms. When you go to the hospital, they have to. Why in the world then you go to the hospital, the first thing they give you, what do they give you? Somebody said, teach, Holy Ghost. The first thing when you go to the hospital, amen, especially the emergency room, they give you a form to fill out. On the form, it asks you your name, amen, your date of birth, amen, your social. It asks you, glory to God, some symptoms, amen, praise God. Please understand, they will never diagnose you, amen, praise God, because of what they see. They will diagnose you because of what they hear. My God, from Zion. That's why the Bible said faith cometh by hearing. They diagnose you because of what you said. So when they give you the form, you check it. Have you ever had heart attack? Is there anybody in your family with cancer? Is there anybody in your family with tumor? Is there anybody in your family, amen, with asthma? Is there? And you check. As you check, what they do, they use the form, the information, and diagnose you and then treat you. Watch what's problem is some of us have passed the information. If you had sit down with him, if you had sit down with her and ask the question the right way, speak Holy Ghost. Watch this, I'm taking too long, but let me teach it. Watch this, Minister Chanel. When you go to the emergency room, emergency doctors do not panic. When you get in there, you are panicking. You are having a fit. You are having, amen, all kind of stuff. But listen, I never go to the emergency room and they're panicking and said, "Ma'am, hurry up and fill out the paper. Hurry up. We need to. No. Everybody's calm. The receptionist give you the form and she's calm. He's calm. Amen. Praise God. Just waiting on you to give the information so they can get you in the room so the doctor can read and diagnose you. What's your problem? Mothers and fathers, you're panicking. You already skipped to diagnose instead of getting the info. What's wrong with the child? Lord, what's wrong with you? Check. I'm not sleeping. Check. You haven't been paying me much attention. Check. Okay. Then you can diagnose. Some of you, let me help you. Can I help the church? Say, Holy Ghost, help the church. You know why there's so much divorce in the church? Because we're skipping. We're not diagnosing. We're diagnosing before. First of all, the problem always starts at home. The problem starts at home. Believe it or not, the problem starts at, y'all ain't thumbs up this morning. Are y'all hearing this? Y'all okay? The problem starts at home. If home get it right, school will get it right. If school get it right, our community will get it right. If our community get it right, the church will get it right. Because it starts from home. We send them to school. School take them through the process up to 12th grade college. Release them into the community. And then you come to church. or better yet, church. No. Y'all hearing this? The reason why we have so much divorce is because you're not talking. Help the church, no Jesus. You are not talking. There's no dialogue. Your children come home. The first thing they gone on is the phone and the TV. Your husband come home. You on the phone. You don't know what kind of day he had at home, at work. You don't take no time to talk. You busy on the phone. Girl, child. Oh, this is my day. I mean, I'm still in the spirit. Hey, koshata mandaya. Girl. Oh, that's my husband, girl. And you keep on talking. You see, if you ever talk, there will be less problem and more solution. Half the time when a woman divorces a man or a man divorces a woman is, honey, we don't talk. We don't communicate. I don't know what's going on with you. I don't know what's the problem. Oh, God, but you give me this man. God gave Rebecca twins. The twins were struggling in her womb. Rebecca went to God and had a talk. Rebecca said, God, you put this baby in me. Why is this happening to me? You gave me this. I was barren. I was barren and you open up my womb and allow me to conceive this child. Why is this happening? Why is this happening in my marriage? When you gay, I pray for him. I pray for her. But you never tell him, baby, I don't like this. I don't like that. You don't communicate. Some of you shut down and shut in. You don't talk. How is he going to know what you're locking, woman of God? How is he going to know what you want, woman of God? How's she going to know, man of God? Because there's no dialogue. There's no form. You don't check out, but you're going to diagnose. So what do? You go to diagnose. What is going on with the church? There's a big problem in the church. Speak, Holy Ghost. Reveal this to me more. Instead of you, glory to God, go to godly counselors. You go to a psychology that was taught by man who already had about 3-4 divorce. The person, amen, praise God, the professor that taught the psychology that is psyching and counseling you had 3 divorce. What do you think is going to happen to your marriage? You got to find God fearing, godly. Nobody, if I ever have a problem, ain't nobody that don't know Jesus going to counsel me. Amen. Praise God. The Bible said, Paul said, when we were born, the Bible said we were born in sin and shaping iniquity. My God, that means, amen. Praise God. But Paul said, when I want to do good, evil is present. There's a war in my member. My God, then if you don't have God, my God, and the Holy Ghost, then Lord Jesus, God help you. But watch this. You went to a psychology to psych you out. My God, that don't know God. Amen. Praise God. So they can't give you no godly advice. They can't give you nothing that says work out. Amen. Work it out with patience. They won't give you no godly advice. They won't tell you seek the Lord while he may be found. They won't tell you call upon Jesus because he's near. They won't tell you, glory to God, that there's a spiritual battle that is going on behind your son. They won't tell you there's a spirit that is working behind your husband. They won't tell you that your husband is being troubled with a Jezebel spirit. My God, with a lust spirit. That's why he keeps cheating on you. They won't tell you, wife, go down in prayer and target the spirit of lust and command that thing to leave your husband. My God, so he stopped cheating. My God, they won't tell you that. But they will diagnose you with divorce and say, glory to God, he cheated on you. And I remember when my wife did it and I served her the divorce paper. Isn't it funny that Rebecca didn't even go back to Isaac? Isn't it funny that Rebecca did not go back to Isaac when Isaac was the one who prayed for the baby to come in her womb? She went to God. And she said, why is this happening to me? And God said, there's two nations in your womb, because I know the thoughts I think towards you. I know the plans. I know your future. I can see beyond the walls. I can see beyond your vision. You're having problem because you're going to the wrong source. You're having problem because you're approaching the thing wrong. Have a talk. Sit down and communicate. Sit down and talk to your husband. Talk to your wife before it's too late. I don't know why God is having me here. I thought I was going to preach about the barrenness and your womb open up. I thought I was going to be on cloud 9 by now. I think I'm on cloud 10. God said, after she inquired of the Lord, this is what the Lord said. Two nations are in thy womb. Two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels. One people shall be stronger than the other. And the elder shall serve the younger. In other words, God give her insight. She went for her answer spiritually first. The answer come back from the spirit. Confirmation. Release come in the natural. Manifestation come after. You gotta go. God, you gave me this. Why is this happening to me? A lot of you this morning are having a why. Well, let me give you the answer. How you are approaching this thing. Who are you going to with this thing? It's causing a problem. Daniel, when he went into 21 days of fasting, the king had a dream. He had a problem. The soothsayers, the visionaries, could not tell the king the interpretation. Daniel was called upon and Daniel said, give me some time. Give me some time. Let me go inquire from Jehovah. Give me some time. Let me get on my knees. Give me some time. Let me bring my marriage before God. Give me some time. Feel the anointing. Let me bring my husband, my children before God. I don't know who I'm preaching to this morning. But you're having serious issue with your children. And you're not approaching it the right way. And God wants you to do it different. Try it this way. Sit. That child down. Humble. Calm yourself. Calm down, mother. Calm down. Hilo shanda. Ababa shekanda labahai. I pray that God give you a calm spirit this morning. Let me get back. God said I should get back to the husband. You woman of God, that won't take time out for your husband. Do you know that man? Lord Jesus, where am I going with this? All right, speak, Lord. Man do not speak a lot. I'm going to tell you why they don't. Kadia shababa sike de de bandi osaya. Robo koto shika mandi andarabahandi andanamaso. Watch this. A man has a mentality. I am the breadwinner. I can't show weakness. I cannot cry. I can't let her know that I'm struggling. I can't let her. The most thing that a man needs from a woman is not intercourse. He needs support. Ketarobo koshaka mandayas, help the church, Jesus. He needs support. A man, watch this, don't like a woman that is disrespectful, that talk all the time over him. A man doesn't like a woman that is controlling. A man don't like a woman that never ever can be submitted to him. Because you have to understand, they were born as a leader. They were born with a mentality that they are always the head. They are the leader. They are the breadwinner. Amen. They got to do this. And sometimes your husband is struggling and you won't know because he won't talk. But if he ever have a wife that says, amen, you got to know when to approach that man. Somebody, I don't know why I'm here, but let the Holy Ghost help the church. Sometime, woman of God, with your sanctified praying, fasting self, you got to know how to get into that room sometime. Amen. When he's laying down, glory to God, thinking, or when he's, amen, reading, or when you just got to go in and just rub his head a little bit, say, baby, how are you today? How was your day? Amen. How you doing? Amen. Praise God. And sometimes you got to know, glory to God, when to go in and say, amen, praise God. He says some things like, babe, amen, we can, amen, praise God. I want to start my own business, babe. I feel like this. And you got to say, babe, you got to know how to give him a response. I said, yes, babe, you can do it. Because he needs support. All right, I got to teach this. Amen. I asked God for a bigger church so I can get an office for myself, so I can have counseling in the week, because we need to help the church. He needs support. Men are not emotional. Men are not emotional. They're not emotional beings. They were never created as that. Women are emotional. And I'll teach this. I'll go deeper into teaching. What time is it? My time is probably up. I guess I have to teach this another day. Men are not emotional beings. They were never made that way. A man can have 4-3 women. And while you are hurting, wondering, why is he doing this to me? He thinks he's doing nothing. They're not emotional. They have some kind of emotion at some point, but they weren't created to be all that emotional. So what happened now? I'm going to do this teaching. I want to take this a little deeper, but I'm going to wait until I'm teaching. Ooh, somebody help the church, Jesus. When you as the wife come in, some of you are too bossy. You miss your gender. Mm-hmm. Help the church, Jesus. I wonder which song we can play for this. Somebody find me a song. Some of you too bossy. Controlling. God made Adam first, not Eve. As much as who I am in God, the Lord has humbled me years ago to understand, to keep a marriage and to keep a husband. Amen. You got to follow the godly way. Are you going to have problem? That's why some of you divorce in 2-3, amen, weeks. Glory to God. And 1 year, because, amen, praise God, you're too hype. Lord, don't make trouble Zion for this money. Sister Doreen, I don't come to trouble Zion. Let me come off of this line. Eco Shataya. You don't know how to humble yourself. You don't know when to speak. You have to know when to speak. Listen, a man, you can win a man's heart. You can win over. Glory to God. Amen. But it's the approach. It's when. 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 When do I talk? When do I listen? Man, study him. Study her. I tell people, glory to God. Amen. Praise God. I told, amen. Amen. Praise God. A young man came in, amen, in our office one day. Amen. Pray. Kato Shatayamahanda. Came into our office one day. Amen. Praise God. He saw a young woman in the church. He said, I like her. I like her. I want to get to know her. I feel like I need to teach this though. I'm a stop. I'm troubling Zion. When you was a single woman, you could have been bossy. When you was a single woman, you do what you want to do. You spend your own money. Kedabashataya. But when you get married, you're not single anymore. Some of us live in a single, some of you, not us. Glory to God. Let me take that back. The blood of Jesus here. Some of you live in a single woman life with a ring by your finger. Some of you live in a single woman life, but you say, I do. Help the church, Jesus. You're losing your husband. You're losing your marriage. Because you're ignorant. And the church is going to the ungodly to counsel them. You tell me God no have no godly see of sanctified man of God. No example to teach you about marriage. To counsel you on marriage. Marriage is of God. And you live like a terror egg, like a bully in your marriage. And your children see it and become bullies in class, bullies in society, because you projected that on them. And yet the Spirit of the Lord said, humble yourself. Under the mighty hand of God. Humble yourself. Listen to somebody. Some of us know we too much. We know all. Nobody can teach us. Nobody can tell us nothing. Amen. Well, prophetess, when did you get your degree? 15 years I've been married. Going 16. Mm-hmm. Yes, saints, yes. I am certified, qualified. I got access to speak the way I'm speaking. Every anniversary, my greatest reward. Can I tell you what it is? Somebody said, talk it, no prophet. Talk the thing. When me talk the thing, people, them day. Praise God Almighty. Do you know why? What my greatest reward is? Every anniversary. That me and Pastor Palmer are still in love. In love. It's not just, I love you, Sarah. I love you, Samora. And I'm in love with you still. After all this time, you have to bring balance to your family or you're not going to have a family. God created us with balance. If you balance your marriage, you will balance your children. If the children are balanced and we release them out into school, they won't go to school with a bully spirit
a disobedient, unruly. Lot of time you see, Lord God, children, amen, acting certain way. It's what's going on in the house, Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, don't trouble Zion. Hold on, I'm going to play this song. Me need a mug that said, don't you trouble Zion. Let me play this song because Lord, 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 you said Zion have a key. This year one. Whatever we release in our home, we release our children to go to school. And they bully other children. Because the wife in the house bullying the husband. The husband in the house beating upon the wife. Don't trouble Zion. Let me sing this song. Don't trouble them. My time is up. Don't trouble them. Me not bother them. Me not trouble them. Just attack with the Holy Ghost, give me. Rise and come out of there as a balanced meal. Mm-hmm. I have to give you a balanced meal. Yesterday we jump. Yesterday we walk. Today we teach. Oy, oy. Lord God, somebody just saw a seed. You have to tell me where that seed for. I touch and agree for balance. You hear the man say, walk holy. That means if you walk the walk and not talk the talk only, you will get better result. Number one, let's take notes. Let's take notes, Zion.
Then you're the afflictions of the righteous.
Take notes. Number one, we're still with the house. We're bringing order back. Number one, for the wives and the husband, you have to communicate, talk. That means if there's an issue in the house between you and your husband, talk to your husband, talk to your wife, work it out. Get your checklist, write down what the issue is. You don't like this, honey? All right. You don't like how I do this? Okay. You don't like to eat this? Okay. You want dinner? Okay. Wife, I like when I come home. You already start cooking. Amen. Wife, I like when I come home. Can you run me a bath on Tuesday? Listen, you're going to change up some things. You hear me, wife? Some of you having problem in your house. All right, babe. Okay, so would you like this? All right. But when you know, Lord, how may I go? Yes, so Jesus, my time. Don't trouble Zion. I don't know what's going on this morning. Wives, let's do something special. You know, say I come home by 5 o'clock. You can go to the dollar store, you know. It's cheap. I'm still in the spirit church. Get some little rose. Pedal, get some stuff. Him a come home by 5 o'clock. You're used to him regular time. He come home every day. Do you know sometimes he's having hell at work, but again, he's not really emotional and he feel like I can't tell her everything I'm going through because she gonna panic. The children are gonna panic. She gonna think I can't handle it. She gonna think I'm a mama koshi and da da baha. She gonna think I can't do it. I can't. So guess what? You gonna... You come home at 5, set a little bath. Run the water a little bit. Let me tell you. One Valentine's Day in my early marriage. Me not going to tell you everything when me do. Pastor Bryce, my mother, when me do? Me and Pastor Palmer, we never had it like that. I went to the store and I get some little dollar curtain. I had this beautiful, amen, a drape curtain. Mighty God. The curtain have like a little red flowers on there. It's just pretty. You go to the dollar store, you get little, amen, the dollar store have little, amen, container. You can cut up a little bit of fruit. Some of you stop dieting. That's the problem. You stop dieting. Cut up little melon, little apple, little stuff. Put it in at the little dollar store container. Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah. Set the table a little bit. Amen.
Lord Jesus, why am I doing this? Dollar store have some little thing where you call rose petal. Them fake. Glory to God. That's all right. You don't want the real one anyway. Because you can reuse it for your later date night. Eh, karaba shatabaha. Am I still in the spirit, Zion? Edabahana. Am I in the word? Run the bat about 5 o'clock. Him about for come through the door. You're used to it on a regular routine. Him a come home, amen. Praise God. Run that bat. Glory to God. Keep it at a certain temperature. Good God Almighty. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let the pedals come from the door. Glory to God. Amen. The children are still at school. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Praise the Lord, Zion. Mm-hmm. Help the church. When he comes, you don't know what kind of day he had. Cook something that he like, his favorite food. Cook his favorite food. Yes, Lord God. Make sure say it done pan time and stay warm. Mm-hmm. Run a look about. Don't make it about you all the time, Lord Jesus. You have to know if you accommodate your husband, accommodate your wife so you can keep your marriage. Some of you don't know how to keep home. That's why you have so much difficulty. Lord, don't trouble. Let me play this song. Where you say, man of God? Where you say? Let me play this song.
The Lord delivers him out of them all. Jehovah, Raha, he is my shepherd.
For my single ladies. All right, hold on. That Valentine's Day, I set the table, I cook the food, I clock him. Get some stuff, run the bath. When my husband walk in the house and see, him not know say a dollar store, me go. He not know how cheap or how expensive it is. All he knows is she took the time out to cater to me. Can I tell you that whatever the problem is, you're just shifting. You're shifting mindset. You're shifting mood. That night that you can't have no argument. Let me play this song. Me a trouble Zion. Leave them alone. Why? I mean, the word Rebecca said, God, why am I thus? And she went to inquire of the Lord. Oh, yo. Holy man of God, holy song. I'm almost finished. Rebecca said, God, why am I thus? You know, Mommy Doreen, I was praying, and all I keep hearing while I was praying is, why am I thus? Why is this? That's all I kept hearing. So I find the scripture and Rebecca said, God, if you give me these babies, why are they struggling? Why is there a contention in my womb? And God answer her. Some of you asking God why, so I'm answering. He's answering you. My time is up. I gotta go. You want to keep your marriage? Number two. Stop going to ungodly people for counseling for your marriage. Stop going to woman, amen, single woman for marriage advice. Stop going to people who have 4 or 5 marriages for advice. Play this song. Timer up. That number two? I reverse it back. Number one, your prayer. Number two, communicate. Number three, stop going to ungodly, unsafe, ungodly people. Counselor, psychology that is not safe. Professors that are not safe. Expecting to save your marriage. Number three, after you get that together with your marriage. Number four, you got it. What you are projecting in your house is falling on your children. It's falling on your children. And some of you, your children are acting up because mommy and daddy keep on fussing, keep on arguing,
keep on. And then guess what? They go to school and they play it out on other children. You know a child that is a bully, amen, praise God, don't just, there's an underlying issue because something is going on in the house. They're having issues. They feel rejected. They're uncounseled. There's no attention. So they go out and they act out at school. Some of you, your children, the grades change. It's because they're not getting your attention. Some of you, your marriage is going under because he ain't getting your attention. Every day you want, girl, listen, shut that phone call down. Sometime when your husband come in, Lord, put the phone aside. And I tell my daughter, Maya, it's the weekend now. Put on the phone and make, sit down, make we watch a movie. Sit down, make we talk. Some of us so super spiritual, you can't even watch a movie with your husband. Can't even watch a movie with the children. God help the church, no? Help the church, no, Jesus. Leave them alone. My time is up. I'll teach this on another day. I believe God is going to bless us with a location where I can, amen, praise God. Amen. I have my own office to do my godly counsel so we can have less divorce in the church. Everybody share the live this morning. God brought me on here to talk to you. Leave them alone. Don't you trouble Zion. Jody says, seek wife's counsel, seek godly counsel. Godly counsel. Godly counsel. Godly counsel. God bless you. This morning is my early morning. Our time. Rebecca said, God, why? We have to walk it. We have to walk the walk. Mothers, wives, mothers, this morning, you know what you're going to do? Go back to the song. Mothers, so this today, you're going to go home, you're going to sit down, and you're going to talk to your children, those troubled ones that you're having problem with. You're going to ask God for a calm spirit and you're going to talk. Wife, this week, I want to tell you to start dating again, your husband. Let me make it plain. Start dating your husband again. All right? Do something special for him this week. Husband, do something special for her this week. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all hearing me? Y'all hearing me? You're going to do something special. It don't have to cost you much of anything. It don't have to cost you much. hear me? Wife, pray in the morning, pray in the afternoon. By the time you come from work or she come from work, do something special. Do something special. Blow his mind. He never expect it. Blow her mind. She never expect it. She not expect it. Pastor Palmer, me not expect it. Pastor Palmer, me not expect it. Praise the Lord. Let me play the song. Praise God. Do something special this week.
Do the impossible.
Jesus.
Blow my mind. We want to see your
hey God. Some of you don't know it, but he's been giving you a hint. Catch it, no man. Praise God. God bless you.
To the impossible. I cannot see.
Don't make him see this one, but it'll come. Praise God. Susan Fairweather Joseph, you hear what I said? Hallelujah.
I can imagine what you have in store.
Marriage is a beautiful thing.
Thank you, Father.
Ears have not heard. I can imagine.
I'm gonna tell all the wives this morning. I'm gonna tell all the wives. You can do it. Listen, woman of God. Woman of God. I'm gonna tell you the secret. Now talk to the single people right now. Y'all gonna wait on the Lord. Bible said, wait on the Lord and be of good courage, and he will strengthen your heart. He's coming, daughter. But watch this. For the married woman this week, if I even dollar tree, me not think Pastor Palmer, listen. If I even the dollar tree, go this week, one day this week, do it. Cook some in favorite food. I don't know why I'm there saying, but God help the church. Cooking favorite food. Just do something special. Lord Jesus. The other day, Pastor Palmer had his birthday, December gone. You know what I do, saints? Lord Jesus. Me say, me run, go down at the store. Drop the kids in my school. Run, go down at the store. In a Publix. When me get to the store, me see some flowers. Me want to get him some blue and white flowers, Sister D. When me get to Publix, we get the look of blue and white flowers. Me see blue and white flowers, but them have other colors in night. Me tell the woman of God, me say, you can't separate them for me. Just put all of the blue and the white in this and take out the other color. She go tell me, say, me for buy the two rows. Ah, Jesus, him there on the line. Anyway, me go talk the thing. The woman go tell me, send me for buy the two rows. And then me do this. Me say, no, call the manager. They call the manager. They won't call the manager. We call the manager. The manager said, just take it out and give it to her. What's the big deal? Just do it. The man of God birthday. Praise God, Sister Paulette. Happy anniversary when it come 21 years. Mighty God. Talk your secret now. Amen. Cause some secret in other marriage day. Why you keep it 21 years? Come on, church. Woman of God, man of God. Me buy the rose and put Alyssa some, you know, chill her somewhere. Kids gone to school. And me know me do? Me drive, go down at the man of God job. A woman of God, you think of you alone forget rose and chocolate delivered to you. We go flip it this year upon them. Praise the Lord Jesus. Y'all hearing me? Because y'all quiet. Me scream quiet. Me get the blue and white rose. And me get, remember when me get, oh, we got Chick-fil-A. and get some breakfast. Special delivery upon him birthday. Run go down and drive down at the job. And just walk in at the job. Walk in at the job. And deliver the rose myself. Praise the Lord. Can I get a praise the Lord? Deliver the rose with the breakfast we like. You can imagine the smile from Pastor Farmer face. Cause all I'm co-worker, let me play this song. Me think of this happened to him.
Father, do something never done before.
Happy birthday. Sometimes the simplest things, the thought, act out.
Blow my mind.
Act out the thoughts. Act out the thought. Walk
to
out the thought. Hey. God bless you, saints. I'm gonna go for real now.
Blow my mind.
Praise the Lord Jesus, somebody.
We wanna see your hand
go. Why the single people them quiet? Just laugh with it on that song. Your idea come. Me not even see Sister Romaine, Sister Cheyenne. Where them there?
Eyes have not seen. Ears have not.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Father.
God is a balanced God. He's not always speaking in tongues.
I can imagine what you have in store.
So can we all lift it up?
Blow my mind.
Just one hand and just say that into your own atmosphere. Blow my mind.
Blow my mind. We want to see miracles, God. Blow my mind.
Do the impossible, Jesus. Do the impossible.
Do the impossible.
Now you know what I want to say. Blow my mind, God.
Blow.
Father, I thank you for your word today. Thank you for speaking, Holy Ghost. Thank you for teaching. Father God, I only speak, Lord God, as you lead me and also as an example. I pray now, God, and I seal the word that went forth. I seal the prayer that went forth. I seal the seeds that were sown, that they will bring an harvest, God. Not only that, God, but I seal my marriage one more time with the blood of Jesus Christ. Blanket my union, my marriage, God, with the blood of Jesus. Cover us and continue to unify us. Continue to strengthen my marriage. Continue to help us to be a light and an example to the believers, to the body of Christ, to the saved, to the unsaved. Cover us. I pray against every backlashes and retaliation that will come against my marriage, my children, the ministry, God, and even this life this morning. I seal it all
The devil will not have any power, and no weapon that come against my marriage or my children, they will not prosper. I speak it, I pray it, I declare it this morning. I seal my marriage. I seal my children. I seal my relationship with the blood of Jesus Christ. I seal the word. I pray for the marriages. I pray for the children. I pray for the heirs that they will take heed to the word that was spoken this morning, and that they will bring forth fruit in Jesus Christ's name. I cover myself under the blood. Cover my children and my husband under the blood of Jesus. Thank you for taking me through this day on Rise and Command Your Day. Bless the sowers, those that have sowed today, those that have sowed for their marriage today, those that have sowed for their children today, for the hand of God, for the wisdom of God to apply to the lives of their children, to their relationship. Those that sow, God, for their children, for their marriage. Ay, hallelujah. God bless them this morning and keep them. In Jesus Christ's name. Church, say amen. God bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Love you all. Enjoy your day. Amen. Glory to God. Enjoy your day today. And remember, do something this week. Okay? All right. Y'all be blessed. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Jesus.